scripture reading from this morning is from Mark chapter 1, verses 9 through 13. Listen for the word of the Lord. At that time, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. Just as Jesus was coming up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased." At once the Spirit sent him out into the wilderness, and he was in the wilderness 40 days, being tempted by Satan. He was with the wild animals, and angels attended him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So living here in New Jersey, we might picture the wilderness as something like a forest. But wilderness in this context would actually refer to a desert. It might be just as intimidating and lonely as a forest. But rather than trees all around, a desert would just be a sparse, empty landscape that Jesus was in. Jesus faced trouble and temptation, but he could also see clearly all around him. He had 360-degree vision. He could look up at the sky and see the stars. He could see them far brighter than we do now. Our stars are obscured by city lights and pollution. But for Jesus, the stars were perfectly clear. They were vivid. And in a desert with no distractions, he could look up and see the stars and thank God for them. And he felt God's presence as vividly as he saw the stars. He faced the fear and loneliness of the desert with the knowledge that he was not truly alone. After 40 days, Jesus left the desert and returned to a busy and complicated life. Now he had even more temptations and trials than those he faced in the desert. But he had the clarity, because of those 40 days, to know his path despite all the distractions and difficulties. We are called to this as well. We are called to love and serve God with thankfulness despite our complicated lives. Lent is a time for us to return, to reflect, to reconnect to God and one another, and to recognize God's activity in our lives and be thankful for it. During the season of Lent, one of our communal disciplines together has been for each of us on our own to practice the prayer of Examen each day. This prayer, the prayer of Examen, is a technique for prayer which is based on the work of St. Ignatius of Loyola, who was a Spanish mystic who wrote in the 1500s. And he believed that the key to a fuller spiritual life was to learn to see God in all things. The prayer of Examen is intended to help us find God's presence in every aspect of our lives. We may not be able to go off into the desert for 40 days, but we can take a few minutes each day to recenter ourselves. Many of us have done this on our own throughout Lent, and as we near the end of Lent and Palm Sunday, we're going to spend some time today practicing this prayer together as we prepare for the coming season of Easter. You probably noticed Linda and Amy back there. She and some of the other members of the Wellness Center have contributed to the collage that we've been compiling throughout Lent. And they have contributed photos and words about how they feel God's presence. For some of them, it's through yoga or other healing physical activities. For others, it's through art or writing. Linda is coloring a mandala, which is a kind of tool that helps many of us to focus on God. And you'll be able to see it after the service. It's especially helpful, mandalas, and you can find one in your bulletin. It looks like this. It's especially helpful for those of us who are hands-on people. Or for those who always have to be moving or doing something. So you can watch her draw if you like. You can watch Amy draw. Or you can color your own mandala in the bulletin as we pray. Or you can draw or write on your own if you prefer that. I personally find that writing helps me feel God's presence best. We often talk about how there are so many different learning styles. So in the same way, there are also many different prayer styles. And I invite all of you to try something new today, or just do something that you know works for you. I hope this will encourage you to understand God's presence in new ways. The questions for the prayer of Examen are printed in your bulletin, and you're welcome to follow along with me, or to use one of these other creative tools to help you focus. While the musicians play, I'll read one question at a time for you to reflect on silently, however you choose to. So let's pray together.
Thank you.
after looking back on your day, consider the thoughts and ideas that came to you.
Thank you.
God, we entrust ourselves to your will.
Open our hearts and minds to your presence, today, tomorrow, and every day.